Hey, 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 what's up, Facebook? And also in the Zoom room, we have FNKO tonight. It's FNKO. No, it is not Funko. It is pronounced FNKO. And it's just like over there to my top. I don't know which side you're looking at, but over there. So FNKO started off as a series of coffee house style performances. And believe it or not, we've actually been around for over 10 years now. We started in 2010, July of 2010, and here we are. It's actually been one whole year since, you know, we've been sheltering in place, and about one whole year since we started FNKO, the virtual performances. So here, virtually, it is slightly different. Well, I'd actually say it's pretty different from our live version because you get a more prim and polished version of most of our performers. Some of us, you know, we just practice and we play, we just record it in the time that we have while we're working from home. Some people are taking care of their kids, doing all kinds of different things. Because even though we're sheltering in place, there's still things we have to do, right? So anyways, the virtual performances, they are pre-recorded and they're submitted to us. And then you're here with us to watch these. If you want a better viewing experience, I'd highly encourage you to join me on Zoom. You should be able, if you're on Facebook, you should be able to find that in the description of this event. So right now, I actually want to encourage all of you guys to share this event with your friends. Share it on Facebook, you know, share it, I don't know, text it to people, send it on Messenger. And I'm actually going to do that for our webpage that we have, or actually our Facebook page. I like to share it there, let people know that we are here, that we're live right now. Our next FNKO is actually going to be held on April 24th, another Saturday, and it's about a month from now. And we want to encourage you guys to join us. By joining us, it could be that you come here and you watch and you support us by watching. Another way to join us is by actually participating. Here at FNKO, we love to have, you know, more and more people join us. We have some of our regular FNKOers. You know, you'll see a bunch of them tonight, but also tonight we're really blessed to have a lot of newcomers, new FNKOers to join our community. And so I hope that you will give them a warm FNKO welcome. But yeah, right now, oh, hey, what's up, Joyce from Chicago? And Eric, yeah, thanks for the noticing this chair I have. Obviously it's fake, you know, but it's pretty cool. I loved it. I love changing the backgrounds on Zoom. So anyway, right now I want to encourage you guys once again to share this event. If you're on Facebook, share it with other people, let them know we're here right now so that we can support these somewhat local, sometimes they're from farther away, but for the most part they're local creatives who are just trying to share their passion with you. I have three screens set up right now, so that's what I'm looking for over here. So yeah, with FNKO, what's great about the virtual one is that we do try to create community still. When we're live, it's wonderful because you get to sit, you know, with the performers, you know, you get to talk with them in between pieces, you know, chat with them afterwards. We hang out sometimes, we go get food, you know. I love, you know, Fat Wong's over there on El Camino. Shout out. They don't watch this, I'm sure. But, you know, it's a great community that we've built here at FNKO. And so what's different virtual is, you know, we aren't face to face, but you can still interact with each other. You can still engage with one another and support and show love to the performers by using the comment section in Facebook. So I highly encourage you guys to do that because our FNKOers, they love it. I love it. I love seeing that you guys are out there, that you're actually engaged. But I know maybe you can't watch it right now. So you can use the rewind function if you need to. So, you know, at a later time, just go back, or if you want to watch the performances again, please do so and watch it again and again and again. But here at FNKO, you know, we're here to create a safe and supportive and encouraging environment for people to share their passions. So that's what's different about FNKO compared to, you know, other open mics or other places that people perform, is that FNKO, it's not a competition by no means, you know. I wouldn't even call it necessarily a talent show, but it's more of a passion show, you know. That we're able to show each other what we love to do. Some of us, we love to sing songs. We love to play music. Some people like to write music. Sometimes we have spoken word. Sometimes we have poetry. You know, another thing that I'm hoping to bring up during this year is forms of art. So there may be some art events and artisan, you know, people who do crafts and things like that. Hold on, I'm trying to share on our Facebook page. If you're not a fan of FNKO on Facebook, please do that. It's facebook.com/1FNKO, because there's only one FNKO. So let's share that. All right, and now you guys should have my undivided attention for now. So as I was saying, it's not a talent show. It's not a competition. These are your friends, your neighbors. These are people who live down the street from you, who are in your family, you know. A lot of us, we have 9-to-5 jobs. You know, there's I work at UCSF for clinical research in cancer. You know, we have lawyers. We have people who work at Genentech or different places, you know, nurses, whatnot. Everybody's from everywhere. And that's what we love about this, that it's not necessarily like professional people, but it's just people who want to share with you what they like to do. So really quickly, here's QR codes for you. The blue one, I have to, let's see, get my fingers right. So this one, the purple one, this is a QR code to our website, so check that out. And yes, I'm sorry guys, I need to update it. I'll get there, I promise. You know, it's just, I'm sure you guys can relate. I didn't even realize today is spring. Happy first day of spring. But you know, time is flying, and I have a lot of things that I want to do, but I'll explain a little bit of why I've been kind of lagging with stuff. But anyway, purple is our website, blue is our Facebook. Made it easy for you guys. All right, so let's get started here with some performances. The first performance is usually by yours truly. I like to do that because I usually, like when we're in person, I like to just get my first, you know, myself over with, like just get my jitters out. Because honestly, every time before FNKO, like I feel like almost like sick to my stomach. But my friend, you know, has long ago, like the words always play in my mind. The day that you are not nervous is the day you should be worried. So when you're nervous, it's fine, you know, because things will go well, you know, you'll have some fun. That's all that matters. But the day that you stop caring, that's going to be the time where you should really be worried. Like, what's happening, Melody, you know, and self-reflect, do some heart checks. But anyway, so I wanted to share with you guys, this first song is called All I Can Say. And honestly, this past, I'd say like, month and a half or so has been pretty rough, guys. For me, you know, I do a lot of things. I'm working. I'm trying to plan these events to build our community here. This morning, I teamed up with some of my friends, and we actually put together a pop-up. Shout out to Sweet Passion Bakery in the Sunset District on Terravel. They let us, they hosted us as we did a pop-up to raise awareness and raise funds for the Asian American Pacific Islander community, AAPI. Because I'm not sure, I'm pretty sure most of you guys have heard already in the news. But what's happening is that there's a lot of hate crimes, and they're directed towards Asians right now. And so, you know, we want to come together as a community and raise our voices and let them know, like, we're not going to stand, we're not going to sit for this stuff, you know, that we have to stop the hate. And, you know, this shirt, I wanted to point this out because my friend gave it to me. Thanks, Lauren. But it says, "You want a piece of me?" And actually, recently in the news, there is a woman who was attacked on market, an older, like, I think she's like 70 or something, Asian woman who was attacked. And she actually fought back and she beat him up pretty good, actually. I'm not, I'm not trying to push violence, actually, quite contrary. I do believe in standing up for yourself, and I do believe in defending yourself, but I am not about violence. But, we do want to say, like a lot of our elderly in the Asian American Pacific Islander community are being attacked right now. They're aiming for our grandmas, our grandpas, our lolos, our lolas, we, as Asian Americans, Asians, we tend to take care of our elderly. So this is hitting us pretty hard. It makes me think of my grandma. It makes me think of my, what we call her nanai, on my mom's side. But we need to take care of them. So I want to implore you guys, if you see some elderly Asian people walking around, you know them. They usually have pretty cool clothes. They're pretty fashionistas usually. Or they got their bags and they're going grocery shopping. Just kind of keep an eye out for them. Make sure they're okay. Okay, guys? But anyway, we need to raise that awareness. And actually today we raised, it's pretty crazy, in less than 2 days of planning and in less than 6 hours today, we raised $5,000 to send to the stopaapihate.org. They're raising funds to help, with just the politics behind all of this. So anyways, that's my spiel on that. But also, a lot's been going on because, I just found out that one of my uncles on my mom's side passed away. And the week before that, one of my uncles on my dad's side passed away from COVID. And then about 40 days before that was one of my friends, our friends, one of our brothers, Glenn Grievous, he actually passed away. And so I've just been like, having it pretty rough, and it makes it hard sometimes to live life, when you're just like thinking and you're seeing all these things around you, all this news. So I want to share this song with you guys because it kind of says how I feel. It says like, all I can say, this is all I could do is give my everything. And like, even though I'm tired and I'm tired, like physically, I'm tired emotionally, I'm tired mentally, just giving my all to God and giving my all to the community, and still pushing through the tiredness of everything to provide. So anyway, here we go. Let me share my screen with you guys. I hope you guys do like the background. Oh, and also if you are in the Facebook chat, once again, want to highly recommend that you engage, you participate, you chat with them. Let us know where you're watching from. Let us know how you heard about it. Would love to hear all that stuff. So, all right. Here we go. So this is me, Melody Gawliu, and performing All I Can Say. And All right. So yeah, that song is called All I Can Say. And I don't know about you guys, you know, like how you guys feel lately. This whole pandemic, you know, has been just pretty draining. And yet still kind of invigorating in some ways. You know, I feel like my creativity has been able to be fed through this time, trying to find ways to be creative during the pandemic, new ways to do things, new ways to live life, new ways to connect with people, you know. One of the things that is difficult during the pandemic is when you have someone pass away during it. You know, there's actually this movie called 5 Feet Apart that I watched right before the pandemic hit. And if you get a chance, if you have Netflix, you know, watch that movie. It's actually, I feel like you'd be able to relate to what's happening. In it, they're talking about cystic fibrosis, but basically it's about these people who have this disease that makes it so they have to stay 6 feet apart from each other and from other people, you know. So anyway, I feel like most of us can relate to that. But, you know, we all need that human touch. You know, there's nothing like it. And right now, being a hugger, like I'm a person who loves to hug people, honestly. Like, and one of my love languages for how I show love to other people is physical touch by, you know, giving them a pat on the back, giving them a hug, or whatever it is, you know. So it has been pretty difficult, but especially when you lose somebody, you know, being unable to find the comfort that we need physically at times. And so when our brother, our FNKO, or our friend Glenn passed away, you know, it was pretty difficult because we couldn't be there for him and his family in the way, like at least that I would have wanted to, you know, like just grab them, you know, and hold all of them, you know, and like just being able to have those intimate moments of being close with other people. But, you know, the last FNKO that we had, we actually had a tribute, a dedication to him. And we had lots of people turn out to support him. And we're glad, you know, that they were all there and that we could all just remember the impact that Glenn made on our lives. And I know, you know, for a fact that Glenn's spirit, you know, that spirit of positivity, spirit of encouragement, you know, just being excited, just being down for everything, right? That will live on, and especially through FNKO. He was a huge supporter of it, and I know that he was always hustling, trying to get more people involved. And we do actually have a couple of them here today, and I'm sure that there will be more as time goes on. And that's what I'm saying is, like, Glenn, you know, he continues to impact me, you know, because he always supported me, and it was, you know, like, especially those times where I was feeling kind of, like, unsure about FNK, unsure like what to do next, but he was always down and always like, you know, if it's just gonna be us two, like, we'll do it, you know, we'll perform, it's gonna be fun, but we'll still get people, so don't worry about it, you know. So one of the people who actually watched last time decided to, you know, join us. So there's a lot of new FNKOers here tonight, but this first one, her name is Jen Tabuso Meyer. I think that's how you say her last name. Please correct me if I'm wrong. I don't know how you'll do it phonetically on Facebook. but I'm actually just going to read to you guys the blurb that she wrote. All right. So just put on your hat thinking, you know, I'm Jen speaking to all of you guys. Okay. So here it is. She says, "Hi, FNKO community. I'm Jen Tabuso Meyer, also known as Jen Tabuso, from Daly City. I wanted to thank you for providing an opportunity to contribute to this great forum of such talented artists, and I want to share that I'm actually doing this in honor of my old friend, Glenn Grievous. Like many of Glenn's musicians' friends on here, I grew up in Daly City, and in the late 90s, talent shows and singing was a huge outlet for many of us, including myself." Remember, I'm talking for Jen Tabuso. Okay. "I remember being with Glenn and Rhythmic." Rhythmic is the singing group that Glenn was in with Eric and some other friends. "In the same talent shows around Daly City and also at El Camino High School, where we all went, Elco. I treasure those days and look back on them with so much love and appreciation. To honor those days, I chose this song, Forever Young, as it hits home and reminds me of a time when life was full of fun, friendships, and laughter, a time when we were all figuring out ourselves. May we all have the same zest for life, love, and laughter, just as Glenn did. So here we go. This is Jen Tabuso, and she is performing Forever Young. Let me share my screen with you. And like I said, show her some love. She's a new FNKOer. If you're on Facebook, oh, there she is. She's chatting right there. Yeah, go on Facebook, chat her up, show her some love. Let her know you're listening in. If you're watching later, you can still do the same thing. All right, here we go. All right. Wasn't that amazing, guys? Like, seriously, she's a first-time FNKOer, but obviously it's not the first time, you know, at this singing rodeo, right? Like, it's amazing. I was saying in the Facebook comments that her voice, like, Lea Salonga reminds me of her, you know? Like, I could totally, like, imagine her at, you know, like, a musical or just, I don't know, there's so many songs that come to mind I like want to send to Jen. Like, Jen, can you sing this one? That's one of the great things about FNKO, though, is that, you know, like when you're listening to people's voices, you know, hopefully it's inspiring you guys to come out here and to participate in the future. Like I said, you know, acoustic music, spoken word, poetry. In the future, we will have some events tailored towards art and artists and crafters. But anyways, we're really glad, you know, show her some love, show Jen some love, because we want her to come back. We want her to keep singing. She's out in Sacramento, but she's, you know, homegrown. I'm from Daly City too, and also from Elko, El Camino High School. So, you know, shout out to all the Elko heads. There's actually a bunch of us on here tonight, which you will see. So let's see what we got here. Oh yeah, someone noticed my pizza shirt. Once again, yeah, you want a piece of me? And I do want to point out my earrings. You guys couldn't see it, but check that out. It's a piano and then a G clef. And actually, as part of my signature, I actually write my last name using a G clef when I do my signature. All right, guys. So up next, let's see, who do we have up next? So up next, it's so funny. This guy, this brother, he sent me this piece, like, I think it was the day of the last FNKO or maybe the day after. And this is what he said. He said, "I'm bored and going crazy." So I made a crazy cover for those going crazy. So I am going to let you guys see. This is actually one of our FNKOers who's been with us for a long time here. This is Charlie V, aka Charlie Victoria. So show some love and chat him up. He is there in the Facebook chat. So here we go. Charlie.
All right, let's try something different.
Guys, Wasn't that crazy? I'm watching like all the comments here on Facebook, and people are just like amazed by his beatboxing. And like, I gotta tell you guys, it's nothing like seeing it live. And that's the tough part right now, is that we can't have the live performances just yet. We are looking in the future, hopefully the near future, to have our live performances again. And we will still have a version of this online, virtual FNKO. But when we are able to meet up, some of us have been talking about throwing a huge, outdoor barbecue so people can still social distance, hang out, but we'll also have some live music outdoors. That would be pretty cool, right? Let us know what you guys think about that in the chat on Facebook. But I got to tell you once again about that beatboxing. Okay, it's nothing like seeing it online, that beatboxing and that thing he does. I don't know if you guys could hear it, like the ornamentals, the twinkling in the guitar. But his fingers just move so fast. It's just like crazy to watch like in person. You couldn't see it in that video there, but man, it's crazy. And I do want to say also, how many NSYNC fans are out there? Any NSYNC fans? I know it's always like NSYNC, Backstreet Boys. Everyone's always, we're always fighting when I was younger and they were out, right? But anyway, NSYNC, they had this song, Dirty Pop. And it was kind of like this 80s like pop song where it's pretty like electronic and stuff like that. And in that song, actually, Justin Timberlake, he does this beatboxing. Well, let me tell you, okay, I watched the making of the video. Do you guys remember that? Okay, sorry, I always get, I always digress here and there. But okay, there used to be the show called Making the Video, and they showed NSYNC doing that Dirty Pop song. They showed Justin Timberlake doing the beatboxing, and in actuality, he's not really beatboxing. He does pieces of it, and then they put it all together to make it sound like he's actually beatboxing. But here, Charlie is actually beatboxing while playing guitar and doing all that stuff. It's amazing, okay? We have such great talent here. All right, so I just had to get that out there for you guys, because as I was watching, I was thinking about it. Okay, so next up, we actually have another song that we actually didn't get to play at the last FNKO, where we did a tribute to our brother, our friend, our FNKO, or Glenn Grievous. And this was actually an original song written by one of our FNKOers. Her name's Tracy Ma. You guys have seen her. She usually has the cool lights in the background and kind of like, cool like dark shadow on her, but the light in the background, pretty sweet. So she wrote this song, as she reflected and just thought about, Glenn and, how he was a bright light to us. Here at FNKO. So I hope that you guys enjoy it. It is called Silencing the Pain. And so let me pull this up for you guys. And I do want to point out, it's pretty cool, like the video. Tracy does a great job at the videos and stuff. And one of the things for FNKO, one of our slogans is inspire and be inspired. And it's like just this like back and forth, this call and response, that as the performers inspire other people in the audience also inspires the performers. But hopefully you guys feel inspired, and if you have not yet performed at FNKO, maybe you'd be interested in the future. Once again, plug, our next one is April 24th. That's in about a month. You have about a month to figure it out. Let me know if you guys are interested. A lot of people learn instruments or start writing poetry or doing things so that they could perform at FNKO. And we hope that you will do the same. All right, so once again, this is called Silencing the Pain by Tracy Ma.
I wish I could say out loud the words buried deep within, somehow caught under my skin, hiding behind the smile. So stop, breathe, my dear, 'cause I will always be here on the happy days, the darkest hours. Don't be afraid of falling over. I'll be your pillar always. open up my heart. Suffering silence feels better. Shrouded by those hurtful words, please just hold me tight. So stop, breathe, my dear, 'cause I will always be here. On the happy days, the darkest hours, don't be afraid of falling over. I'll be your pillar always. Whenever you need me, just call me. Don't hesitate to ask, 'cause I will pull you out of the darkest hole. So stop, breathe, my dear, 'cause I will always be here. On your happy days, the darkest hours, don't be afraid of falling over. I'll be your pillar always. So call me.
So once again, that was an original written by our very own Tracy Ma, one of our FNKOers. She's been with us for a long time, and she wanted to pay tribute to our brother and our friend Glenn Grievous. You know, it's hard to like watch some of these things that are, you know, paying tribute to Glenn, because it's just like, you know, like thinking about Glenn not being here and not having a new piece from him. But we're searching our archives to see if we can pull out some stuff for future FNKOs, because the live ones, a lot of you guys out there have never seen it because it was live. but if you do want to see some of our past FNKOs, you can see them on YouTube. I need to update a lot of things, and our YouTube is pretty up to date. I'll put in the new ones from tonight, but yeah, so stay tuned for that. The next performance we have for you guys is a guy I've known actually since kindergarten. We went to kindergarten, middle school, high school together. And actually, let me read to you guys just his little bio here for you guys, because I've actually always known that he's been a great singer, and he was part of a singing group called Composure, and it's an R&B soul hip hop group that was managed by DNH. Do you guys know DNH? Where my Asians at? DNH was Dropping Harmony back in the day, back in the 90s and 2000s, and actually Composure, they went on hiatus for a while, but they're back. Because a lot of them at that time when they were on hiatus, they were actually doing their solo projects. But now they're back, and we want to encourage you guys, show them some love in the Facebook chat. But also, you can follow them, check them out on Facebook. Just find Composure 41510. And on Instagram, it's composure.music. So if you're on Facebook and you look up Composure, just make sure it's not the group from the Netherlands. It's some Filipino brothers, so look for them, okay? Because I made that mistake, so I had to check with Mike to see what the correct one was. But yeah, this is Mike, and he's actually doing this song called I Need You by the Donnelly Brothers. So let me set you guys up here. And then we'll get you guys started. Let me share my screen. This is once again Mike Brito. He's part of a group called Composure, and this is his solo quick video he sent us.
Every single the day. The tears won't stop from falling, 'cause the pain won't go away. To be in love with someone and call my wife my dream. I know it's only been 3 months, but an eternity it seems. I look up at a picture of a family torn apart. And what about the children? How will this whole thing play out? There's only one solution, and it's all so very clear. Lord, I need you.
All right, so that once again was Mike Brito, and he is from a group called Composure. Show them some love. Find them on Instagram and on Facebook. We're looking forward to hopefully having more pieces from him, and hopefully in the future some originals by Mike and by Composure. But we'll see, you know. But Mike had shared with me that that song, I Need You, by the Kennelly Brothers, that it was a snippet of a gospel song that holds just heavy weight to him. And, you know, I want to encourage you guys, when you listen to music, you know, try to listen to the words when there are words. You know, how do you relate to that music? How do you experience that music? That's one of the things that I love to do. Why I love FNKO, you know, I get to listen to music, especially music that I may not have ever come across on my own, you know. I think many of us, we kind of stay in our bubbles, right? Not just because of the pandemic, but just in general, like, you know, we have this bubble of comfort, right? And it comes in all different forms, like the friends we hang out with, the places that we go, also the music that we listen to, right? And so, anyway, FNKO is great because it pulls you out of that bubble, at least for a little while, you know. Try to experience. Some people don't listen to R&B. Some people don't listen to gospel music. Some people don't listen to country music. You know, the first song that I performed earlier, All I Can Say, don't be afraid to rewind to go watch the other performances from earlier. But, you know, that was a mix of kind of like country slash, you know, Christian music, right? So anyway, here you get to experience all these different types of music, all these different styles, and that's what we love here. And actually, speaking of me, I have one more song for you guys that I want to share with you guys. You know, honestly, it's hard to choose songs a lot, and I've been lagging in choosing songs. So my goal for the next FNKO is to choose my songs quickly and then do a more... like detailed, more like a better video. Like I'm watching Tracy's, you'll see like Kevin's later and a bunch of people, like their videos, like, you know, it's beautiful to see how their creativity is coming alive because of this virtual performance, right? That they actually put in the effort for their videos. But me, I'm in my bathroom. I tried to, you know, like make sure there wasn't any weird stuff in the back, you know, like back of me, like toilet paper or stuff. But anyways, I just chose this song because I liked it. It's a song called Latch by Sam Smith. I am usually drawn to songs that are very heartfelt, that, you know, just kind of like pull and tug at your soul and your heart. But I also love fun songs, so don't get me wrong. But this song's called Latch, and I want to encourage you guys. You know, this song is about latching on to someone that this person loves. But for you, it could be, you know, someone that you love, you know, it could be something that you love. But I want to encourage you, when you find that thing, latch onto it, you know, be enthusiastic about it, hold on to that, you know, don't let it go, hold it as your precious, you know, like, what is that movie? Lord of the Rings, my precious. Okay. Anyway, so this next song is called Latch, and, it will be by a cover by yours truly. Here we go. I tricked you guys. Wait, that was the wrong video. Let's do that again. Here we go. All right. So that song was a cover of Latch by Sam Smith. And actually, I can't remember, like, he actually did it with someone else, and it was actually, like, not an acoustic song, but I really liked the acoustic version of it. So that's the kind that I tried to imitate. And that's the thing with music, right? Why I love YouTube versus Spotify versus... I don't know, Pandora, right? Because on YouTube, you get to see all kinds of different people, all kinds of different versions of music, all the different kinds of versions of songs. You know, it's so cool. Like whenever I'm trying to learn a new song or I really like a song, I start listening to all the different versions and I'm just like, wow, you know, but it makes it hard when you're practicing because it's like, what version do I want to do? Like this song, I could have played more like, you know, like, as if you're like kind of slow jazz, you're at a cool, you know, lounge, you're just hanging out and chilling. Or you could do it more upbeat and fun, you know. Although those high parts, you know, they when you do it faster, it can get a little trickier. But sometimes, you know, and that's a thing like with music is, you know, just for me, I'm like, just let your heart out, just let your soul out. And so those high notes, I'm like, wah! You know, just wailing at it. But I hope that it encourages you guys, you know, to feel like you guys want to give it a go. You want to try. And actually, I found out that the next performer, her goal is to hopefully submit a piece for every FNKO, at least one. And so I'm really excited to see if she'll be able to keep that goal for at least this year. Her name is Serena Zen, and she is going to be performing a song called You Light Up My Life. And listen to her vocals, you know, like I wish we could get her like in studio and just hear her runs and just hear her vibrato and things, like what it really sounds like up close, you know. So anyway, this is Serena, and she's performing You Light Up My Life. And here, let me share my screen with you guys.
So many nights I sit by my window, waiting for someone to sing me his song. So many dreams I kept deep inside me, alone in the dark, but now you've come along, and you light up my life. You give me hope to carry on. You light up my days and fill my nights with song. Rolling at sea, adrift on the water, could it be finally I'm turning for home? Finally a chance to say, hey, I love you, never again to be all alone. 'Cause you light up my life, you give me hope to carry on. You light up my days and fill my nights with song. 'Cause you
Wow, was that amazing? Yeah, don't you guys agree? I love that song already, right? But it's so great to hear, you know, one of my friends, she's a friend from church actually, you know, just pouring out her heart and singing this song. I always appreciate her song selections. And like, did you guys hear what I was talking about? That vibrato she has? Yeah. Like, it's amazing, you know? So definitely show her some love on the Facebook chat. But also, I did want to point out the modulation. Did you guys catch the modulation? If you don't know what a modulation is, it's when in a song you go from one key to another. And it can be pretty difficult, especially when you're playing an instrument, but also as you're singing, like modulating to another key. That's tricky. So good job, Serena. Like, great job. It was awesome. All right, who do we have up next? All right. So next up, we have another longtime FNKOer. Actually, it was funny. On Fridays, a few of us have been doing this thing. We're testing out this new creative space that I love coming up with names. So for now, I've called it FNKO Creative Co-op. You know what a co-op is? Well, I'll talk more about that another time. But anyway, so some of us have been, you know, meeting together and talking about this, and he's one of them. And actually, we watched his first performance at FNKO. I think it was like back in 2012, 2013. And man, it was just so cool and so fun to watch. I remember being there live. But also, it's cool to see where people, you know, have come from, you know, when they first start off at FNKO, where they are now. And for those of you guys who don't know about FNKO, once again, it's a place for people to feel safe to share their passions, their creative passions. You know, it's not a competition. We're not here to judge. We're just here to share in what you love to do and encourage you. Come on, do some more, right? and hopefully by encouraging you and watching you do your thing, other people, you know, the rest of us, we also feel like, oh, I want to do that too, you know? I feel like that's what happens a lot when people, like, look at Etsy or they go to those artisan fairs. They're like, I don't know if I want to pay for that because I feel like I could do that, you know? I do think we should support people, though. But if you could do it too, you should do it, you know? But anyway, his videos, you know, are usually inspirational to me because it's like, that's the next level that I want to get to. I have all this, you know, like music equipment, and I'm just using my little, you know, Samsung S20 to record my songs. Like, Melody, what are you doing? You're wasting all this stuff, your resources. But anyway, so the next performer is Kevin Wong, or KW, and this song is called You Somebody. Originally by Kings of Leon, and we hope that you enjoy it. Let me set you up here, share my screen. All right, here we go.
Check. I think I'm falling for you.
All right, so that once again was Kevin Wong, or KW, performing his rendition of Use Somebody by the Kings of Leon. And I said this in the chat, but I'll say it again. You know, it just reminded me, like, I think that's a beautiful thing about songs. Like, it can take you to places, like, back in your past, you know, transport you back there or to places or with people. And for me, his rendition just brought me back to when I would travel for sports, like in high school especially. Like at nighttime, we'd be driving back and I just sit there, you know, just chilling and watching all the cars and the lights go by. Like, that's what that song reminded me of. I'm like, oh, you know, it's nice. All right, so the next song that we have, the performer, actually, her name is Monique, and she actually, what she wanted me to say for her intro was, Monique, singing Blackbird. She wanted to keep it nice and simple. But I do want to give you guys a little bit of the background of this song. It's Blackbird by the Beatles. And actually, when discussing the song, John McCartney, you know, he's one of the Beatles, he said that the lyrics were inspired by hearing the call of a blackbird in Rishikesh, India. But alternatively, also inspired by the unfortunate state of race relations in the United States in the 1960s. And I wanted to mention that to you guys because how far have we really come? You know, we've come far. But still, there's all these, you know, like issues with race relations right now. As I said in the beginning, you know, I want to raise awareness for the AAPI community, the Asian American Pacific Islander community, that right now we're being the target of a lot of like violent hate crimes, not just hate crimes, but violent ones. You know, the people in Atlanta, you know, those women there. Like, I just heard that on Thursday, this past Thursday, a couple streets over from where I live, an elderly Asian woman was mugged and like pushed over. And there's actually a video of it. And it's just crazy, you know, to think like what's going on. And, you know, I hope that in our community, you know, we can show, you know, get the little foretaste of what life could be like if people would just show some love to each other. You know, where all we wanted was to support one another, to encourage each other, you know, that it's not about who's better, you know, who's worse, right? But it's just about, I'm here, you're here, we're all on this earth. Let's find a way to not just coexist, not to just tolerate one another, but to love each other, to encourage one another, you know, to support each other. I think that that's what we should be doing. And actually, I don't know if you could, yeah, you can't see my necklace, but my necklace is actually, has a Tagalog, a Filipino word, and it's the word for peace. It says kapayapaan, which means peace in Tagalog. And that's what I'm praying for, you know, God, give us peace. And it all starts with, you know, me. And it starts with you out there, you know. Just one person can make a huge difference in the world, if only in your little circle of influence, you know. But why not be the start of that? Why not be the start of encouraging and loving other people, right? So anyways, this next song, like I said, is Blackbird. It's performed by my friend Monique. She actually, you know, I went to elementary school, and I think middle school with her, but I think she ended up at South City instead of Elko. I can't remember right now. It was a long time ago, guys. But anyway, Elko head or South City head, doesn't matter. We're all here on earth. We're all human. So Much love to you. Okay, here we go. Let me share my screen and we'll get you guys started.
Blackbird singing in the dead of night. Take these broken wings and learn to fly all your life. You're only waiting for this moment to arise. Blackbird singing in the dead of night. Take these sunken eyes and learn to see all your life. You're only waiting for this moment to be free. Blackbird fly, blackbird fly into the light of the dark black
That was beautiful, right? And like another, like, it was just kind of chill song, and I was just like watching her play guitar and feeling inspired. Like, I want to continue building my craft and practice more. But Melody, what are you doing? You know, there's so much to focus on, or so many things out there that I want to help out with, or I want to work on, and it's hard to focus, you know, sometimes. One of the thing is for FNKO, you know, like, we want to build the branding. I actually had ordered some of these cute little keychains, and because there was like a special deal I saw on Instagram. But I'm working on rebranding and getting some merch and stuff like that. If you guys have any ideas, or if you are a graphic designer, want to help out, throw some ideas out to me, or if you have event ideas, would love to hear that too. Like I said, I do have a lot of big plans and some plans for this year, like bringing an art or artisan and crafters kind of event at FNKO, you know, aside from our music one that we have here. Our next FNKO is April 24th, so mark your calendar. And on Facebook, actually, the event is already live, so you can invite other people, say that you're going, hopefully you're coming, and hopefully we'll have you guys maybe even performing. I don't know if you're watching the Facebook chat there, but I'm trying to convince some people to come on, you know, come and perform, you know. It is scary. I'm not going to lie. It's scary, and it's scary on online, and it's scary in person. But that's one of the beautiful things about FNKO is it can help you build your confidence and make it less scary. You know what I mean? That was one of the reasons for FNKO, was to help build people's confidence, build their stage presence, or give them more exposure. And maybe they don't want to perform somewhere someday. Maybe they don't want to, you know, like, go to the Grand Ole Opry, or, you know, whatever is the equivalent to not country music, you know, Shoreline Amphitheater or something. Maybe that's not their aim. But maybe it's just, I just want to express myself, and I just want to be heard. And dude, I love that. That's what I do. You know, I just want to be heard a lot of times. So thank you, everybody who's here, for hearing all of us. But we're not done yet. So let me introduce the next song. Like I said, you know, creativity, it's so fun, you know, and being able to express it in different ways. I don't know. Okay, let me ask you guys a question out there. How many of you guys play Animal Crossing? Any of you guys play that? I don't play that. I've just heard a lot about it. I don't know anything about it. But this next performance is actually a coworker of Tracy, you know, one of our FNKOers. And now he's an FNKOer because he's performed here. You're an FNKOer because you're watching. But anyway, he's actually a coworker of Tracy's from the music school that we used to have our live performances at. Vibo Music, shout out. Hopefully we'll get back there soon. Or if you know any venues that would donate their space to us in the future when we can meet back in person, you know, all of these events are funded from my pocket, basically. And so usually I try to see, you know, how I can get people to help donate or do something like that. So if you know any spaces or any, you know, like hookups to get printouts or shirts and things like that, let me know. Anyway, okay, enough of that. The next performance is actually, he teaches piano and violin, and he makes covers of video game songs on the side for YouTube. And so this is actually one of his performances, and it's a song from Animal Crossing. So pay attention if you play Animal Crossing, let me know how legit it is. I'm pretty sure it is. So here we go. Da, da, da.
Thank you.
All right, guys. Was that crazy? I'm just like, whoa, are you serious? Did you see all those instruments? Okay, it brought me back to the days in middle school. I was in band. I was also in sports and in leadership, but this brought me back to band. When our teacher would have us do assignments where we had to sit and just listen to music and write down all the instruments that we hear being played. That would have been fun to do for this one, you know? I was like looking at all the instruments and I'm like, whoa, 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 whoa. And there kept coming like more and more and more, you know? He broke it down, you know, with like the violin and then the accordion, guys, and the French horn and the flugel, like whistling. Well, once again, just to plug him, he does teach at Vibo Music. He teaches piano and violin there, but dude can play like everything, and it's mama, you know. The only two things that I could think of that were missing off the top of my head was, and I was waiting for it, I was like, okay, there's no singing. And then I was like, is there gonna be kazoo? You know, kazoo? I don't know. Okay, well, anyways, I'm seeing the time here, and you guys know it's hard to contain everything to 7 to 8:30. So if you have to go soon, like I said, this is being recorded, so feel free to go pause, come back here, watch it again later. You can start where you left off. You could watch it from the beginning. You know, you can kind of find maybe different people that you want to listen to in particular. But, you know, thank you for joining us here. So up next, we have a piece that was submitted by one of our FNKOers, one of the newer ones. Her name's Megan Cheng. And she actually sent this song. It's called I Will Wait For You. And it's originally by Keith and Kristen Getty, but they did the Shane and Shane version, if you're familiar with them. And so she says here, originally this was part of a song set for our college fellowship's alumni night, led by some UC Davis alumni from AACF, Asian American Christian Fellowship. I think that's the one she went to. It was our first time doing this not in person, so she had no idea what to expect, but it was tons of fun putting this together, and they hope to provide some encouragement and hope during this time of the pandemic, and just during this time while we're here on Earth, of course. And she wants to give a shout-out to Andrew So, who is on guitar and vocals, Allison Ko on vocals, you'll hear another piece for her later, and Ethan Tanamura on cajon. And she didn't mention herself, so just see if you can piece her out in there. But once again, the song is called I Will Wait For You. It was just audio, so I just added a picture that I had taken one day. So here we go. Share my screen. I always feel like I have this need to tell you that I'm going to share my screen while I'm trying to figure out how to share my screen. Okay, here we go.
Places I will call. Incline your ear to me anew and hear my cry for mercy, Lord. Were you to count my sinful ways, could I come before your throne? Yet full forgiveness meets my gaze. I stand redeemed by grace alone. I will wait for you. I will wait for you on your word. I will rely. Surely wait for
Wasn't that song just super peaceful? And I'm not stopping my share screen just yet because I wanted to just point out that picture. That's actually out in Pacifica. And I just, you know, I went for a walk one day during the pandemic. And, you know, just this beautiful, like, rays of sunshine coming through because, you know, you have the little mist from the ocean. But, yeah, I just felt like this song, the message of it, you know, it's just very peaceful. And anyway, I don't know what you guys picture, but I pictured that. So let me stop share. So we have a couple more songs for you guys. So hang in there. But like I said, if you need to go eat or if you need to do something, you can always pause and come back, or you could just check it out again later. It is being saved on Facebook, so it will be there for you guys. You know, I was just messaging one of my friends because she asked, like, oh, how's it going? You know, how's FNKO going? How are you feeling? And I was like, you know, sometimes it feels weird, or most times it feels weird because I feel like I'm talking to myself because all I see is myself. But she's like, well, don't think of it that way, because just remember, like, you're talking to all of us too, all of us who are here right now and all of us who will be watching later on. And I'm like, yeah, that's right. but it is kind of weird sometimes. I actually do a couple other I don't know what you call them, like events. I have other projects. One of them is my On the Front Porch, which is basically me just jumping on video randomly, just sharing thoughts on, you know, whatever's going on in life, whatever I'm pondering, contemplating. Sometimes it's movies or TV shows I'm watching or music or whatever it is, and I just start talking about it. And also, you know, this song reminded me, like, on Mondays I have this thing called the Annex Worship, where a bunch of my friends from church, we used to do it in person, where we get together and just jam to, like, church music. But virtually it's different, but we're looking forward to that day again. And something else a lot of people have been talking to me a lot recently, so I wanted to get your thoughts. You can private message me or put it in Facebook. But a lot of people have been asking me about if I have a podcast. I don't have a podcast, but now that a lot of people have been asking me about it, I'm seriously considering having one. I already have a name for it, so I hope no one takes it. So I'm going to put it out here to all of you in this virtual space at FNKO, that you guys heard it first. The name that I came up with a while back was A Musing Melody. You get it? I love puns. I love dad jokes and things. My dad is so funny. I get a lot of that from him. But he also gives a lot of wisdom. And that's actually the idea behind, you know, the podcast that maybe I would make one day, is that when you're musing, it's sharing your contemplations, right? Your thoughts and things like that. But hopefully it would be amusing also, where it's like also entertaining, but also encouraging. I don't know. But a lot of people have been asking me, so I'm like, maybe I should seriously consider this. Let me know what you guys think, and if that is something like what you guys would want to listen to, what you would want me to talk about. I don't know. But yeah, and FNKO, like I said, and I'll keep saying it, you know, FNKO, our community, we're always looking for more ways to encourage and inspire one another. So if you have any event ideas or ideas for how to promote FNKO, I do want t-shirts and things, but funds and ideas and you know, making the designs and things, I need help. If you can help, let me know. Anyway, the next song is actually by the female singer of the previous song. It's a cover of a song called Dust by Oh Wonder. I've never heard of them. I've never heard of the song. I've never heard of Oh Wonder. And once again, that's why I love FNKO, because I get to, like, you know, expand my repertoire of what kind of music I listen to, who I know about, right? So this is a cover by Allison and Megan. They've been wanting to do a cover together for a long time, and they finally got to do one together. And then if you want to, if you're able to, Allison actually, you know, she's on Instagram. I'm sure a lot of us are on Instagram, and I'm trying to figure out how to get this stuff onto our website so that people, you know, we can help support one another and connect with each other. But anyway, her Instagram is Allison, A-L-I-S-O-N-H. K-O-U, Allison H. Co., because she actually does a lot of artsy projects on the side. So check her out on Instagram and support her. But once again, this song is called Dust, and it's originally by Oh Wonder, but it's a cover by Megan and Allison. So, this is another audio one, so I just put another one of my photos there. So enjoy.
People try to get you down. Remember that I'm here for you. No one else can wear your crown. It's yours, just yours. When all you wanna do is hide, I'm sitting there right by your side. No one else can steal your light, 'cause it's yours, just yours. Don't you think it's kind of funny? I was spinning round the sun, just looking for someone. Isn't it a little strange, honey? Why'd you need it all that money to buy another dream? It's never what it seems. Don't you think it's kind of funny when people try to get you down? Remember that I'm here for you. No one else can wear your
Wow, wasn't that beautiful? Like, I don't know about you guys, but I'm just sitting here. I was listening to the song, and I'm just like, kind of almost like I'm on a boat on the ocean, just like swaying back and forth to that song. It was awesome. Great job, Allison and Megan. Shout out to you guys. Okay, so just to keep you guys updated, we have two more songs for you guys. Okay. But remember, the fun doesn't have to stop here. You can rewind. But also, our next FNKO is Saturday, April 24th, same time, same link. The Facebook event is live, so you can invite other people, share it with people. We just want to share our space, keep building this community, where it really is encouraging. It's really a place where people can test it out, like I'm not judging you guys, and I'm hoping that all our FNKO community keeps that spirit that we're not trying to judge anybody. We're just here to be like, good job, like keep following your passion, keep sharing that, keep being creative, So anyways, this next song is a song, let me see, let me pull it up, that will throw a lot of us back to. Is this high school, middle school, for some, maybe college, who's watching right now? But this song is called Officially Missing You. And this song has Eric Grivas and Emily Joy Kabitak. Did I say your last name correctly? I hope I did. And if I didn't, phonetically correct me in Facebook. This song. I think, it's a great dedication to Glenn and to all those who any of us have lost in our lives, Sometimes we lose people to death. Sometimes we lose people to distance, to time, But whoever you have or whatever it is, maybe sometimes it's things, it's objects or events in your life that you're missing, right? I think on all aspects, like people can relate to this song and just music in general, right? Like you'd be amazed how one song can mean so much to like so many different people. Like it can be a different thing for each person, depending on their life, depending on their circumstance. So when you're listening to this song, feel free to use the chat to share who you're officially missing, who you're thinking about. But for us in the FNKO community, Glenn Grivas, our brother, our friend, we're missing him. We're missing his voice, his energy. But I do want to share, like Eric and Emily, they both have three kids. Each of them has their three kids and their boys. Can you imagine three boys? And not only, they're three kids, three boys. but that both of them homeschool their kids. So, you know, I know that Eric, you know, he works in the medical field, you know. So just imagine having to go to work, but also taking care of their kids too at the same time, you know, and trying to keep them in line. You know, I want to give props to all those parents who are doing that, you know, because a lot of people don't realize how much work that really is. That's another job 24/7, right? Being a parent is 24/7. Not all of us are blessed with two parents that would give all of that, but for those who are, you know, thank you for doing that. You know, you're raising the future generations and hopefully future FNKOers, who knows. But anyway, this is Officially Missing You by Eric and Emily, their cover. Guys, right? That was awesome. That was Officially Missing You, a cover by Eric and Emily, and I got her last name's Kabitak. So great job. And you know, I don't know if you guys out there realize this, but you know, they're in two different places and then they have to match up their videos to make those vocals work together, you know. And it's so cool, you know, like this time that we live in, that electronics, you know, technology, we're able to do this kind of stuff, you know. And that is why I do appreciate, you know, with the pandemic, I'm always trying to find that silver lining, you know what I mean? Like, that's the only way to get through this life, guys, is you always got to see that silver lining. You always have to remember your hope and remember, you know, like, to look at these positive things. But with the pandemic, you know, being able to figure out how to be creative and use technology to our advantage, right? And, you know, what is really cool is that because FNKO is virtual, that we have this version, we're able to get people who normally wouldn't come to FNKO because of distance or time, and they're able to perform, you know, like the first person that we had, Jen, you know, Tabuso Meyer, she's, you know, all the way over in Sacramento, right? And then we've had someone from Peru before who performed, from all kinds of different places. And hopefully we can get more and more people, you know, to join us virtually, from wherever around the world. You know, we've had lots of people watching from around the world. Shout out to some of my friends out there. My friend Cordula, who's over in the Netherlands. Osman, who's over in Germany, you know. Mubba, who's over in Maldives. I want to say hi to you guys. Thanks for watching. But anyways, this is the next one is the last one for the night. And so once again, if you missed anything, please go ahead, rewind, watch again another day, watch it later, share it with people, you know, let people, more and more people know about what we're doing here. Keep it positive, keep it encouraging. This next song, is actually called Finding Inspiration. And it's one of Tracy, once again, our FNKO Tracy, her friend Roxanne. So this is Roxanne's first time performing for FNKO. And actually, Emily, the one who just performed earlier, it was her first time. The person before that, Allison, it was her first time. The people before that, it was their first time submitting something. We've had a lot of new, fresh blood here, and we want to keep it fresh, but we also love our originals, the people who keep coming back. But yeah, this song is featuring Tracy's Tiger Mama, she called it, and also her drawing. But it's about inspiration hitting you when you least expect it. And so hopefully you guys, when you're watching it, you know, it's a fun video. It has a fun theme to it. It's an original song by Roxanne. So yeah, I'm going to stop talking so you guys can watch it, and then we'll talk a little more afterward. But just in case you turn it off right after, I'm just going to plug one more time. Our next FNKO, April 24th. It's about a month from now. So if you want to perform, get yourself ready now. Start choosing your songs. Start practicing. You know, you can start recording, because I always find it like super hard when you're under the gun and you need to get your performance done, because then your voice, you know, you're like, oh, I need some water. You know, your voice starts going out. If you're playing guitar, your calluses start like hurting like crazy, you know? So don't wait till the last second, you know? Learn from all the rest of us, like our mistakes. But yeah, the next FNKO, April 24th. You know, use these QR codes. The purple one is for our website. The blue one is for Facebook. Follow us, share it, share the love. I'm gonna stop talking. I'm gonna drink my water as we watch this next video. Once again, this is called Finding Inspiration, and it's an original by Roxanne. And you'll see maybe a little cameo by one of our FNKOers. Here we go. Oops.
Zone. but so endless, I don't know where to follow. They go uphill and spiral me endlessly. Directions rising to infinity. I know I can't stay up late forever. So why don't you find me inspiration?
Subscribe for more things. I want to sing, so we've come to the end of the road. Okay. a little bit of live for you guys. So yeah, we've come to the end of tonight. The last bit of FNKO. It's funny because I have like, you know, a laptop, this laptop, another screen, and my phone going to kind of keep track and keep engaged with all of you guys. And so I know that you guys are delayed from what me talking, so it's kind of funny. But yeah, we've come to the end of the night. Our next FNKO is April 24th. I want to give a shout out to my dear friend, my sister out there, Lauren G. Thank you for watching. I know it's your first time watching, and hopefully you feel inspired to join us again someday. Lauren G is actually one of the friends that I told you guys earlier about, that I teamed up with. We think of ourselves as like the fundraising dream team, but we raised over $5,000 to help stop AAPI hate, you know, all the hatred that's going on, you know, the hate crimes that are happening in the Asian American Pacific Islander community. And like I said, you know, peace, encouragement, love, it starts in the individual. You know what I mean? It starts with you. It starts with me, inside of me. How am I going to be interacting with the people around me, with the community? And here at FNKO, that's what we're trying to do. We're trying to spread the love. we're trying to, instead of focusing on being mad at people, instead of focusing on all the terrible things of this world, I mean, you can think about those things, but you can use it, you know, you can use those experiences, you can use those thoughts and do something positive with it, right? And that's what FNKO is about. Like I said, this FNKO, we have music, we have spoken word sometimes, we have poetry sometimes. Future, we'll have some art and crafter events, you know, for that side of the creatives. But yeah, I hope that you guys will join us April 24th. And, you know, like that last song, you know, inspiration can hit you at any moment. But the question is, are you open to it? You know, if inspiration hits you, will you allow it into your life and will you let it flower and blossom into something awesome? That really is your choice. It's really up to you, right? And so I hope that watching FNKO tonight has inspired you. I hope that you do feel encouraged, because that's what we're all about. We're all about, you know, getting people out there, sharing their passions, all of us cheering one another on, because this life is so hard already. Why do we have to make it harder for each other, right? Why don't we just like we're all running a marathon and we're all running alongside each other, and yet we're all cheering each other on as we're going, right? And if someone falls, pick them up, help them out, carry them with you if you have to, right? No one left behind. It doesn't matter if they're not part of your family or part of your particular circle. We're all here on this earth. It doesn't have to be, we don't have to make it harder for each other, guys. So once again, let us know if you have ideas for future events, future branding, you know, ways to let people know more about FNKO, you know, shirts. I love this shirt. Thank you again, my friend Lauren Ng for the shirt. I love wearing cool shirts. I have a special one for next time that someone's sending me. But yeah, let us know any of those things. Also, for a podcast, if you guys really think I should start a podcast, let me know what you would want to hear about, what you'd want to listen to. But yeah, please share this. We need more and more people to know about this space, because we love this space. And now you are a part of our FNKO community. So I hope to see you guys on April 24th. I hope that I will choose my music ahead of time and not wait till the last minute, because life happens, you know. Like I said, I'm going through a lot right now. People around me are going through a lot. We're all going through a lot. You don't know everyone, each person's story who's next to you. But we can help each other out, right? We don't have to make it harder on one another. So April 24th, I hope to see you guys there. Take care, everybody. Bye.